Good evening, everyone. My name is Alzita Biekes, and welcome to our first ever FirstRand Art Unveiling. Yes, we are observing protocol here. we're so blessed for the first time to be streaming to our staff also and to have our Exco members here for the official unveiling of this piece. And we also have the artist in-house, so that's also awesome. You'll get to meet him later. So during the short event, you will hear from our group CEO as well as the artist today. So by means of introduction, FirstRand, we believe that art is a universal language and it has no boundaries. And it also has the ability to capture the spirit of time, transform lives, and bring societies together. We also recognize that its creativity is important for the economy, and that visitors and employees alike need a creative space. So that's why we hope that this piece will also bring some more creativity to our employees and also our visitors. So without further ado, I call our CEO, Conrad Dempsey, just to give us an overall perspective on our art initiative. Conrad?
Thanks, Alzita. They say art is something that makes you breathe a different kind of happiness. And when we started to talk about this, you know, around our building, or various buildings, there's some really impressive art. And you think, why do you have art in the workplace? You know, you come here to work. It's not a national gallery. Why would we have art here? And I think if you look at the data around the world, it's really been proven that short little moment that you can stop there, it's inspirational, it helps creativity, and just helps us breathe a little bit. And I think maybe sometimes we run past our art pieces just too fast. But today is not really to talk about the art that we have or why we're particularly excited about a specific piece of art. It's more around the approach we've taken around the group on supporting the creative economy. Creative economy is a real backbone of society, and creativity in Namibia goes very broad and far. And through various initiatives, we've supported theater over time. We support the National Youth Orchestra. We support the Song Night Initiative, where aspiring artists get a stage. We support the Come Together workshops through the National Art Gallery of Namibia. And we thought, let's take that another step further. And over a period of time, start to directly support Namibian artists, either in sculpting, painting, or whatever medium they use, and buy a piece or two a year to add to our collection. And in that process, not only help support these artists, but also create a stage for these artists. So the intention with this piece that we'll be unveiling today is that it's going to be placed somewhere in the building where it can get the most eyeballs from clients and staff in a day. And over time then, it will find a more permanent home somewhere in the building. And hopefully by then, we found another great inspiring piece and also an artist that agrees to come and unveil it, which can then go to a space that constantly energizes us on what's happening on the cutting edge of Namibian art. So this is step one in a long journey that we do hope to walk with Namibian artists. And I think we can look forward to some really nice creative stuff over the years to come and some really inspirational art that we can all look forward to. So Alzita, for me, it's really just to introduce that wonderful journey that we've commenced on and looking forward to seeing what's hiding here under the cloth today. Thank you.
Thank you, Conrad. I'll now ask Sean van Rooyen just to give us an introduction to the artist, who he also knows personally, and to tell us a bit more about Kapena Joe. Sean?
Afternoon, colleagues. It's really a privilege and an honor to be able to be part of this event. Like Conrad mentioned, I really hope this is the first of many more, where we not just add to the collection for the FirstRand Namibia group, but we also allow for much needed exposure to a local Namibian artist. It just happens to be this artist is someone I know personally from a while back. We've met about 3 years ago. The journey started when I embarked on this ambitious goal of coming out of retirement for rugby and do a couple of last seasons and get the fitness in order. And my wife said to me, listen, you need help. I think most of us can, it resonates with most of us given our current situation. And as luck would have it, ended up with Kapena, as I like to call him, Big Joe. It's not always possible to be sharing a platform like this with men that are taller than me, so I really savor the moment. He will tell you a lot about himself, a little bit about where he comes from and why he does what he does, and also about the piece that we'll be unveiling today. But I want to share a little piece of what I think is relevant for the colleagues on here today, as well as watching us via the streaming link. He was a personal trainer and had a dream of making that a career and paying the bills with that. We all know that with the pandemic and people's habits changing, personal training was not a lucrative industry to be in. And in one of our sessions, I said to him, Joe, this talent that you have, pursue it with everything that you have. He will tell you how everything happened, but the true inspiration, which I want to share with you today, is the fact that he had the courage to pursue this dream of his. And we stand for a lot of things in this group. We have made a lot of promises to ourselves, and courage is definitely one of those. The message for today is I really wish each and every employee and colleague in this group finds their true personal inspiration, pursues it with everything that they have, and make not just FirstRand Namibia, but Namibia as a whole great. Allow me to ask Joe to the stage. He has a illustrious background, but let me not take his thunder and allow him to share a few thoughts with us. Joe, welcome.
Oh. greetings, everyone. Thank you very much for having me here. It's a privilege and honor for me to be able to stand here and share who I am as a person with you. Yeah, 2020, going into 2021, the end of 2020 has been a year of surprises for me. Like, a lot has been happening that I did not just, like, things that I did not comprehend were possible. Like, for me personally, looking at where I come from in the industry of personal training and looking at what's been happening in the world, I just got to a place where it was harder for me to literally just get up and find motivation in what I was doing. And then I decided for myself that, you know what, I literally need to go within my basement and look within myself and try to find myself for what I, or who I really am with from the inside. And that's when I decided to do a small drawing, a rough drawing of Dr. Martin Luther King. And I was amazed by the outcome of the artwork, and I spoke to a couple of my friends about pursuing art itself, and I got the motivation that I needed. But at the end of the day, I needed to go back within my basement again to convince myself that it's really possible to get something like that done. For me, I come from the Kunene, born and raised in Opuo. Sorry, relocated to Grootfontein as a young teenage boy, did my primary and secondary school there, and then I moved to Pretoria on a rugby scholarship. I played rugby for a good 4 to 5 years, and then I just felt like, I remember Namibia called me back, the national team, for World Cup preparations, and for me personally, I remember while we were playing against the baby box, I felt as if something died within me. And at that moment on the field, I made a little prayer, and I was like, God, what are you doing? But the game was on. The ball was moving same side, same side. And in that same process, I did not see Jacques Duplessis, a player who played for the Bulls, and he ran into me from the side with his head and caught me right here. I passed out, woke up in the hospital, and doctor said it's nothing serious. There's no bleeding on the brain or anything. And at that time, that wasn't actually that stopped me from playing the game. I got home from South Africa, and when I got home, I just said to myself, this is not it. I don't want to do this anymore. I don't feel it anymore, because it's easier for you to be able to feel with yourself if you are the type of person that operates from a platform of passion. I've always been a passionate human being. I've never seen myself as talented in the game of rugby. And when I came back from South Africa, I told my family, I'm not going to do this anymore. They weren't happy with me. Most of them felt like pulling my head off my shoulders. But I needed to understand that it's a decision that I need to make. Because in order for me to be fruitful and creative and live out my true potential, I need to be authentic with myself. Going into art wasn't easy at all. I mean, having to conversate with fellow artists and people from this industry, a lot of them told me, don't do it. There's no money in Namibia. There is no way that you can make a career for yourself out of art. And one of the things that I always say to myself is that narrative shouldn't be normative. Just because there is, or people aren't making a living in a certain something, that is not enough motivation to stop me from being the first to do it. So what is the objective? What is the plan? What is the goal? The plan for me and the goal for me is actually to change that narrative. I want people or fellow visual artists to be able to stand and look at their parents in the eyes and say, Dad, I want to become a visual artist, because there is a living in visual artists. And for me personally, being that, making that one of my biggest goals brought me to a place where I needed to practicalize everything in that will help me to get to a platform where I get my artwork recognized. It started with me doing live drawings in the Grove Mall. doing live drawings in the Grove Mall. While sitting there, the one Saturday I felt like, I don't want to go to Grove. I just want to be at home. I don't feel good. Let me just stay home and sleep it off a little bit. I'll go next Saturday. But it's as if I could hear something speaking in the basement of my mind saying, you better go today. You have to go today to Grove. So I ended up packing my stuff, my little easel, a couple of papers, and I went to the Grove. When I got to the Grove, it wasn't busy, empty. And I'm like, you see, you could have just stayed at home. What are you doing here? It's empty, you're just sitting here. You know, and people that are working in the mall, they've got no interest in wanting to actually be curious on what's happening here. So just as I was about to pack off and leave, Mark Dawe came walking past, the MD of B2 Gold Namibia. And that's where it all started. Mark walked over, he asked me, are these photographs? I was like, no, it's drawings. And long story short, this is where we ended up. For me, I'm very thankful to, first and foremost, to those who recognized me from the beginning, B2 Gold Namibia, and I'm very thankful for them to be able to create a platform for me to be able to exhibit my artwork. When I showcased my art to a couple of powerful people in certain departments, for them to give me a platform to exhibit my work, they said, no, but you don't have experience. You can't exhibit your work. First, you need to get experience in order for you to be able to exhibit your work. So for me, those are one of the things that I said to myself, the plan is to change that narrative, to create a platform for visual artists to be able to say, I don't need you to tell me how many experiences I need in order for me to showcase my talent. You know, that's the plan here. So if we can change that, to be able to give visual artists an identity, a platform for them to also understand and feel I'm human first before I'm an artist. So if you are human before an artist, you deserve a space where you can speak from. you deserve a platform where you can say, I'm here, can you see me? Therefore, at my exhibition, FNB showed up, they were a force in my exhibition, the support, Mr. Conrad, Mr. Sean. It's amazing. They called me over, they were like, tell us a bit about this piece. I said to them, the piece that I'm about to unveil today is, I like to say, it's the alpha of many things. Why? Because I say to myself, a woman is compared to the beginning of everything. You cannot have a life without a woman. So I dedicated and I titled this piece as Mother, the beginning of everything. And FNB could have not have been the better place for it to be in, looking at what FNB has done for people, to empower people's life, to empower humanity, and what they have done in my life myself. I'm deeply thankful. I'm very, very thankful to the God of the universe who have ushered people into my life, people that have invested in me, people that have noticed me, people who saw my potential before even I believed in what I want to do. People who said, you know what, you can go far with this. When I used to have conversations with Mr. Sean in the gym, as tired as he used to be while doing his couple of workouts, then he'll be like, Dundetnet. Muni warini, Dundetnet. Bechanet. So for me that has been the angels that have been sent in my life. Sometimes all we need is just that one person that will advise you to go for the very thing you are afraid to go after, you know? And that's why for me it's a blessing to have met people like that. And I'm very, very thankful to FNB for giving me the platform to be able to share my artwork with everyone and with the whole of Namibia. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, Kapena. I think you deserve another round of applause. It was so beautiful. Conrad, if you could join us back on stage. I think this is now the moment we've all been waiting for, the actual unveiling of Mother. So with that, we've come to the end of our very short program. I'd like to thank everyone once again for tuning in. You can also catch this later on in the internet. And also to our EXCO members who have availed the time to be here. Enjoy the rest of your evening and make sure you catch this beautiful piece in the building and make sure that it inspires your day also. It'll be in the building for a couple of days or shortly, and then we'll move it to its permanent space. Thank you.